Welcome to week four of the ISU Junior Grand Prix 2018. I'm your host, Ted Barton, and this week we are on the west coast of Canada in the city of Richmond, just about 20 minutes south of Vancouver. Vancouver and Richmond were host cities to the 2010 Winter Olympics, Paralympic Games, which resulted in new and updated facilities. The Olympic Speed Skating Oval in Richmond is one of those special landmarks that celebrate the natural beauty and outdoor culture of west coast living. The population of Richmond is just over 200,000, which is just part of the larger Vancouver Lower Mainland area, home to around 2.7 million. Import and export, a huge part of the economy here on the West Coast, with shipping lanes to Asia and beyond growing each year. We enter the midpoint of the Junior Grand Prix 2018, and some trends begin to emerge. In ladies, the titles once again are owned by Russia. Anna Shcherbakova in Bratislava week one, Aliona Kostanaya in Linz week two, and last week in Kaunas, the record-breaking performance by Alexandra Trusova. In men, however, there is some difference. Week one by young Canadian Stephen Gogolev, week two by American Camden Polkinen, and last week, Andrew Torgashev, also of the United States, captured the title. In pairs, the top six teams in the standings so far are all from Russia, with the United States, Canada, and Ukraine chasing. In dance, top eight positions in the standings are owned by Russia, United States, and Canada. But the Junior Grand Prix is not only about these countries. Medals have also been won by Japan, Korea, Ukraine, and Italy, with beautiful performances also coming from Hong Kong, France, and Germany, and many other nations. Here we are in Canada. It's week four, last chance for some to gain points towards the Junior Grand Prix final. The pressure is really on, and it begins right now. Hello, everyone. Welcome to day three, final day of competition here in Richmond, Canada. This is a shot of the North Shore Mountains over a golf course here in Richmond. Seaside. Location. Beautiful waterways, islands, lots of seafood, lots of fun. Look outside the Minoru Arena, host of week four. Now live inside the men's free program, about to take to the ice. There are four groups. Nice resurfacing bit after the second group. We want to welcome all our viewers from around the world. Thank you for sending in your notes, pictures, where you're watching from, your very kind comments on the coverage.
Please welcome the skaters of the first warm-up group to the ice. From Kazakhstan, Rakat Brelan. From Indonesia, Muhammad Dwi Rizky Apolianto. From Hong Kong, Hung Lai Zhao. From Chinese Taipei, Shi Yu Yang. From Singapore,
there's the,
Chad
a look
Wang.
At the technical panel for
skaters,
the men's free
you
program.
Have 6 minutes for your warm-up.
Of course, all the judges, and a big shout out to the judges and the technical panel for their volunteer work for the ISU. Thousands of hours of training, judging, to reach this level, the international level, for officiating in the skating event. Thank you for your time and also your passion for our sport.
Thinking about you.
Well, as I mentioned a little earlier, we've had some wonderful comments and compliments from viewers around the world, and we started something yesterday. The number of viewers have sent pictures of their pets watching the Junior Grand Prix. It's hilarious. So if you've got a pet that likes to watch the event with you, take a picture, send it to us. We hope to put something together perhaps a little later in the Junior Grand Prix to show not just humans that like watching skating, also bring some joys to your best friends. You can do that. Send me an email at jgpbarton@gmail.com. jgpbarton@gmail.com. Be great. Again, we thank you for your viewership and enthusiasm watching these young people pursue really, truly beautiful sport. And a look at the start order for the competition. ...21 men in the competition, four groups. Had a growing audience over the last 2 years in the Junior Grand Prix. We had probably a good 1,500, maybe even 2,000 last week in Lithuania. We've had a pretty full arena here yesterday.
Skaters,
this will fill up as the afternoon progresses.
It's
great to see people coming out to the Junior Grand Prix. And a look at the start order for Group 1, just finishing up the warm-up. If you ever get a chance to see a Junior Grand Prix comes close to your area, make sure you don't miss it. It's a pretty extraordinary group of young people. All parts of the world, all different levels, all passionate.
Skaters, the warm-up time has ended. Please leave the ice. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the first competitor, representing Kazakhstan, Rakat Braylin.
Rakat, 14 years old, first Junior Grand Prix season. Hometown was Moscow. Skating to Wings of the Eagle. Curfew.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Kazakhstan, Rakat Braylin.
You see a little bit of dancing there for Jor, because let me tell you, that young man had a plan and he executed it beautifully. He did every one of his jumps that he planned to do. He just duplicated the plan program sheet, which is all laid out, and he did it extremely well. Yeah, some work needs to be done on the spins. That's the weakness here. But jump-wise, wow, he was on top of his game. Not easy coming out of the gate first. You got to be ready and alert, and he was. Here's the triple flip, nice and high and straight and tight. And solid on the landing with a twizzle on the landing edge. Added feature there. Here's the triple lutz. Good height and distance. A little bit forward, not a big deal. Kept that running edge going. Double axle, triple toe. Look at the distance across the ice. Reloads. Keeps that momentum going through the air and on the landing of the triple toe loop as well. That's a good example of a high quality element. Triple lutz. Double toe. He's in the zone. Wasn't on lean, wasn't off at all. There's a triple flip, double toe, double loop. A little tight, probably a little under rotated in the loop. That's getting picky. And look at that triple loop right at the end of the program. They're gonna take a look at the landings to make sure that he was all the way around according to the rules. That wasn't under rotated. He didn't have anything downgraded, this is for sure. But what a great job here in Richmond. And you'll see him stand, and then he'll give a little dance. Yeah, okay, got it. That was awesome. That was fun when it comes together. Yeah, great job.
This score is played. Rakat Braylin from Kazakhstan has earned
103.68 for the free program. That's a good score. With the total competition score, 150.95. Rakat is obviously in first place. He's the first skater. But he really earned that. Oh, there, here we go. Got a personality, I think. Put that on the ice with those jumps. Now we're looking.
Please welcome the next competitor. Representing Indonesia, Muhammad Dwirizki Apolianto.
Muhammad, 15 years old, born in Bandung, second Junior Grand Prix season. Skating his free program here in Richmond. So I'll keep you safe by sleeping at last. Thank you.
now keep it safe.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Indonesia, Muhammad Dwi Rizky Apolianto.
Well, I think all the skaters enjoy performing, but there are some who take the time and are patient to work with the music and have a smile, internal and external smile. And this young man has an external smile and internal as well. And he showed that a couple times in the program. Loves to skate, that's for sure. There's a triple loop, good effort, got high enough, but certainly wasn't tight enough in the air to spin quick enough. But triple loop under construction, good work there. Nice soft knees on the landing of the double lutz. Here's another triple loop. He got all the way around on that. Gonna wanna just tighten up in the air so he has a little bit softer landing, a little bit more time to check out. There's the double flip, good work to save that. Look at here, takes his time, he's very patient, and he comes around, and there's that smile. And if you don't love performing, then you generally don't give that type of expression. Lots of work on refinement, faster spins, turn the toe out, straighter free leg, hold the hands a bit better, you know, little things like that. It's kind of polishing things up. That's really what it is. But he's a skater. He's a passionate skater. And he shows it. Look at that. He's a happy boy. Nice.
The scores, please. Muhammad Dwi Rizky Apolianto.
Free program scores 63.36. A second in the free program.
Correction.
Total.
No, 63.36. With a total score.
Total competition score of
96.88.
Muhammad is currently in second place.
Please welcome the next competitor. Representing Hong Kong, Hung Lai Zhao.
Good, 14 years old, born in Hong Kong. First unit Grand Prix season, coached by Zhao Ying. Skating his free program this afternoon to The Flower Girl by Charlie Chaplin and Salt Lake City by John Barry. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Hong Kong, Hung Lai Zhao.
Well, Hung was searching for air at the end of that program, but boy, you saw the fist pump because for him that was a very, very clean skate. You know, when these young men are just working on those difficult elements and they get them in the program, it's such a feeling of joy. You know, the ability to express yourself and develop the performance aspect comes a little bit later, especially in the boys. In the men, there's the triple sow, Euler, double sow. Focus on the physical part of the sport. Jumping, triple toe loop always feels good in the air, and when you land, it's such a great feeling. The other side of the sport, presentation, the quality of choreography, skating skills, all those things come a little bit later once you feel confident with the jumps. And this young man, he's ready for that now because he's got all those jumps, delivered them all. Now he can spend some time on the interpretation. What a great skate here this afternoon. Feeling of satisfaction in the kiss and cry, waiting for his scores, but I'm most certain inside he feels that's all I can do. That's the best I can do today. He's going to have a great rest of the day. Going. Great skate he delivered this afternoon. Shout out to all the local volunteers. Great thanks for all their work. Let's take a look at the free program score.
Hung Lai Zhao from Hong Kong.
80.80. Coach is pretty happy with that. That's second in the free program with a total competition score of 121.66. That puts Hung currently in second place. Okay, there's the five, the high five, middle five.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the next competitor, representing Chinese Taipei, Sheyu Ye.
Sheyu, born in Taipei, second junior Grand Prix season, skating his free program to Who Wants to Live Forever, tenors.
Who in love must go?
Ladies and gentlemen, from Chinese Taipei, Sheyu Ye.
Well, there's a point in skating for the men, and I remember this myself back in the dark ages, where it's physically difficult. You use a lot of energy because you're using more muscles than momentum and technique. And that's a little bit where this young man is at. He's getting some of the elements done, but not using as much momentum and perhaps as efficient in the air as he needs to be to make it physically easy. He's working harder than he probably needs to, but that will come in time. Here's the double axel off the top. Good speed, momentum, a little on a lean, and he gets stuck outside the circle. Tried to save it by hopping, but unfortunately went down. The second double axel, arms back, through on the free leg, didn't lift up very high. He got off the ice too early, didn't follow through up, just across, get all the way around there. Here's triple toe loop. This is a good save. That's hard work, because he's out of position, free leg is stuck forward, but he kept himself on top of his feet. Little flip double toe, was nicely done. Then some camel work. Needs some work on that camel. Look at the free leg. It's just almost below the hip, which would mean it wouldn't be a camel. You got to lift that leg up. Requires flexibility and strength. Believe me, camels are not guy's best friend generally. Single axle, Euler, double Sacco near the end of the program, maybe 2 foot. Okay. Spinning, a lot of work on spinning. Sometimes need to spend just a couple weeks and only do spins. Get to like them better. Make them a little bit more of your friend. Generally, the guys just like to jump. But good work. Fought for everything. Didn't back down.
The scores, please. Sheyu Ye from Chinese Taipei.
Free program score at 49.01. That's fourth in the free program. Total competition score of 81.63. Sheyu currently is in fourth place.
Please welcome the next competitor, representing Singapore, Chadwick Wang.
Chadwick is 18 years old, born in Singapore, third junior Grand Prix season, coached and choreographed by Derek Delmore. He's skating the free program today to 100. Never Say Never, Little House, all by Frey.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Singapore, Chadwick Wang.
Well, Chadwick is a very, very strong young man. And sometimes, and I remember this myself, is that you feel you need use the strength more than you do. You need to use the strength to hold a position while the momentum carries you across the ice and up into the air. But if you try to force yourself up into the air, force yourself around, then using far too much energy, a little bit more efficient. Hey, listen, good skate here. Let's take a look at some of these things. Good momentum. There's the triple Saukau, too far for it, but gets up into the double toe loop. You want to sense where you land on that blade, right in the sweet part. Don't go to the picks. Keep that flow and momentum carrying backward. There's the triple toe, a little bit forward again. Gets the job done, no question. But for quality and for GOE points, you want to have more flow on the landings. The free leg was a little slow coming out on that flip, a little over rotation as well. Nina Bauer, the triple toe loop, a little forward. Again, you want to use your strength to hold your back and middle part of your body strong. Triple Saukau, which he did much better there. You see how the free leg unfolded, and he was solid in the back. Nice. Not a lot of abilities, but I know what it's like. You're wanting to use all that power you've got. Best you just keep it to hold your body firm. Let the speed and momentum help you. Cry with coach choreographer Derek Delmore, great skater himself.
Chadwick Wang from Singapore has earned
82.94, the free program score for Chadwick.
With a
total competition score of 117.94. That puts Chadwick currently in third place.
Please welcome the skaters of the next warm-up group to the ice. From Turkey, Bashar Oktar. From New Zealand, Harrison Bain. From Malaysia, Kai Zhang Chu. From Australia, James Min.
And there's
from
a look at the standings
Thailand,
after the first group. With two taken to the ice for their six-minute warm-up.
Skaters, you have 6 minutes for your warm-up.
Oh, we've had some new viewers join us and just wanted to pass on a message. We had some of the viewers from around the world send some really cute pictures of their pets watching the Junior Grand Prix pretty intensely too. There was a nice beagle that was just had his eyes focused on the ladies' free program. If you've got a pet that sits with you and watches, send us a picture. Just gonna want to have fun with all the people, the two legs and pets with four legs watching the Junior Grand Prix. Post those a little later on in the series. Once again, a big thank you to all the local volunteers here in Richmond and Vancouver, Skate Canada National, Skate Canada British Columbia, for pulling this event together on such short notice, just a couple months to do so. They may look simple, they're not. That skaters from all over the world, officials from all over the world, hotels, transportation, food, the facilities, the rink floor, everything to make an event like this possible. Thank you all for everything you've done, not only for this event, but for all the events we've had up to this point.
Skaters, there is 1 minute remaining in this warm-up. Skaters, the warm-up time has ended. Please leave the ice. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the next competitor, representing Turkey, Bashar Akhtar.
Bashar, 16 years old, second Junior Grand Prix season, born in Antalya. Skating here in Richmond, free program.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Turkey, Bashar Akhtar.
So that triple axel that Bashar had achieved or accomplished and added to his repertoire last year, he dated him a little bit today. So if he can do it, just at the moment, it's always a challenge. Let's take a look. Here's the triple axel. Solid on the landing, does a three turn and the double toe. Just over rotated. He used so much energy. Sometimes too much. Here's the second one. Triple axel. Arm goes back. Good height all the way around. Once again, over jumped. Certainly strong. Here's the triple loop. That was lovely. Arm movement at the end. The flowing edge is good. Triple Lutz. Saves it. Double toe loop. Right. Hooks it around the corner. Therefore, the GOE, the quality, is going to go down. You want that nice running edge. Triple flip, look good. Free leg for the triple toe loop and didn't get all the way around and the free leg got stuck. Couldn't stabilize that landing. You gotta punch that back yourself right on top of your skate. Here's the other triple left, well done. Nice skater, strong young man. Can do the elements. Just can you deliver it under the pressure of competition? This is Bashar's first time out this year. Hopefully we'll see him a little bit later in the Junior Grand Prix as well. Such a nice young man.
The scores, please. Bashar Akhtar from Turkey has earned in the free program
99.44 for the free program. That's second so far. The total competition score 157.37. Bashar Akhtar is currently in first place.
Please welcome the next competitor. Representing New Zealand, Harrison Bain.
Well, Harrison, 17 years old, born in Auckland, third Junior Grand Prix season. Skating free program today to Fever and Sway by Michael Bublé.
Right, you get a fever. Fever,
Harrison Bain.
Well, that was fun. Harrison had a great time, had a great skate. I was a little worried that partway through his program, he had a spin, and I saw him, we had a close-up shot, and I saw him breathing really heavy. I thought, oh boy, okay, he's got a lot of jumps coming up here. Will he have enough gas in the tank? And he most certainly did. Good job here this afternoon. Such a great feeling when you do your best. Let's take a look. Triple sow, double toe, right off the top. Sorry, triple loop, here it is. Just has to do a three turn. Good save, kept the free leg off the ice. Triple loop, double toe. Here's the double axel. A little forward on the landing, but hangs on. If you want those quality points, you're gonna need to glide out a little bit more, but got it done. Here's the triple sow, double toe. Nice and straight and tight. Again, a little bit forward. So you can see it loses a lot of speed on the landing in the first jump. That's something that he'll work on, and that quality will improve and he'll gain more points. Here's another triple sow. That rode out a little bit better, a little bit more flow. Get up into double flip. And double axel. Again, not a lot of speed into the double flip, but he's fighting to make it all work. So he had a good skate from the perspective that he fought for all those elements to get him done. He did, and in order to get more points now, want to work on the quality. Good speed in, good speed through the air, and good speed on the landing. You can see there, joy. You gotta love that. I just love it when the athletes have that moment for themselves. All the work quietly in a rink early in the morning when it's cold. But that's such a high when you get to feel a great skate.
Harrison Bain from New Zealand has earned in the free program
93.76.
With a total score of
total competition score 144.77. Harris is currently in third place.
Currently in third place. Please welcome the next competitor. Representing Malaysia, Kai Zhang Chu.
Kai Zhang, 19 years old, born in Klang. Third Junior Grand Prix season. Choreographed by Derek Delmore. Skating his free program here this afternoon to earned it and losers by the weekend.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Malaysia, Kaijang Chu.
Kaijang, quite an athlete. Lots of strength, power. Good choreography, some nice moves. Maybe needs to make commitment to those moves a little bit bigger and mean something. We'll look at some of that near the end of the program. First up, let's take a look. Watch this first double axel. Amazing. Arms back off the spread eagle. Look at the flow off the end of the edge and how he opens up and carries that speed. That's what I'm talking about, that quality. Speed on the landing. Here's a triple Lutz. Quickly up in the triple loop, but got on lean. You could see that over-rotated, free leg got sucked forward. But good mechanics. Here's a triple loop, but forward a little bit. It's very good jumping technique and the mechanics, but the execution at the moment is what changes. Here's a triple Lutz, the three turn at the end. Right there, but hangs on. Springs off the ice so nicely, so clean. Lifts himself up high. But the quality of the landing is so important with this new range of plus 5 to minus 5 GOE scores, which the judge can use to add and subtract based on specific criteria for subtraction and specific for the adding. If you've got it, you'll get it. You'll get the rewards. Quality, especially on the landings.
The scores, please. Kaijang Chu from Malaysia has earned
95.07 for the free program and a total competition score of 153.28. That puts Kaijang currently in the second place.
Please welcome the next competitor, representing Australia, James Min.
Well, James is 18 years old, born in Adelaide, coached by Rafael Aritunian. 106.22 personal best, the Asian Open this summer. Skating the free program here to Fifth Element by Eric Serra. That was good.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Australia, James Min.
Well, I want to just talk about the accommodations for a second. It's so difficult to know or decide in a fraction of a second, am I off balance? I am off balance, but can I still pull off the second triple? I appreciate James' effort to go for it, to do it. When you're trying to do a triple-triple combination, you got to measure that balance. There's the triple lutz. Beautiful. He was set up pretty good for the triple toe loop, a little too far forward. So that was worth it. Kept his feet underneath him. Here's a look at the change combination spin. Got long legs. That'll put them somewhere in those spins. That's nice. Lay back. Back camo. He's got a good back camo. And here's a look at the triple flip. Forward. Did he have enough for the triple? No. Made a good choice there. Went with the double. Too far forward, so he didn't have the momentum. Here's a triple lutz. And then he does a Euler, and he tries to go for the triple salchow. Maybe that wasn't the best decision. Had no momentum to work with there. But you have to make it in a split second. There's a triple loop. Well, that was nice. Really an improved skater. But when you're trying the really difficult elements, you have to be instinctive and know, can I pull this off? He didn't back down. He went for it all. Good job, James.
The scores, please. James Min.
Pre-program scores
Australia
for James 100.43.
100.43.
That's second in the pre-program with a total competition score of 148.61. That puts him currently in fourth place. Here's a look at the top five so far.
Please welcome the next competitor, representing Thailand, Micah Kai Lynette.
Micah, 17 years old, born in Honolulu in the United States, second Junior Grand Prix season. He trains right here in Richmond in this facility. You can hear his clubmates cheering behind. Pressure or adrenaline? We'll see. Coached by Keegan and Eileen Murphy, Leah Warwick, choreographed by Jory Russell and Keegan Murphy. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Thailand, Micah Kai Lynette.
What a great skate by Micah. Just that last element. But boy, he delivered this week. Trains here, it's not easy to skate in front of all your club mates, your coaches. Know that everyone back home is watching you online. What a strong, solid skate. The best I've seen this young man put two programs together. Coaches, you can see the big smile on Keegan's face. Happy with that, so he should be. Let's take a look at some of the elements. Triple flip, look at the speed across the ice. A little bit too far forward, missed pick a bit, but he was tight enough, fast enough to get around. Good work there. Here's the double axel. Euler, good speed across the ice. Triple sal gets forward and on a lean, puts the hand down, but still fights it off. Keeps the feet underneath him. And the triple lutz, solid. Deep knee bend up into the double toe. Watch the expression and the movement right in here. That's beautiful. Really nicely done. Takes his time. He's really patient. Triple loop near the end. Boy, he had to really fight for that landing. A little bit on the heel, but he pushes the free leg back nicely. And the last triple lutz gets a nice soft knee bend. What a great job he's done here this week. There's a slip. Wasn't totally on top of the foot on the landing. Just couldn't hang on at the end.
The scores, please.
Program score 106.86. Well, there's a smile from Micah. Finally, here comes from Keegan. That's first in the free program. And a 165.13 overall. This young man is in first. Two more hoops yet to skate. Smile of satisfaction. Let's take a look at the results so far.
Flight at 9 minutes after two.
There it is. Micah just skating 165.13. Ashar Akhtar of Turkey 157.37. And Kai Zhang of Malaysia 153.28. And look at the rest of the field. We'll take a short break during the ice resurfacing. Make sure you join us in just a few minutes. The last two groups, it's going to be some remarkable performances. Everyone fighting for top spots and points for the Junior Grand Prix Finals. Stay with us. We'll be back.
I came across what I was saying, I saw a crocodile came.
Welcome back, everyone, to Richmond, British Columbia, Canada. You're watching live coverage of the ISU Junior Grand Prix Week 4, the last two group of men to skate, and they're all fabulous athletes. See some great performances, everyone fighting for top spots and points. They hope.
Please welcome the skaters for the final. The next warm-up group to the ice. From Sweden, Nikolai Mazurov. From Russia, Matvey Vetlukin. From Canada, Stephen Gogolev. From Japan,
and a look at the standings so far after the first two
from
groups.
Canada, Ferris Clement. Skaters, you have 6 minutes for your warm-up.
Over the past five seasons, the Junior Grand Prix has been gaining momentum, obviously online, with really very large audiences around the world. But we've also seen a spike in the audiences that attend the live event itself. Now, when we're in a building of 15,000, it doesn't look like there's too many. But last week, we had a building of 15,000. We had probably 1,500 to 2,000 skaters. But we also had a lot of young skaters from that local area wanting autographs, getting to meet the young skaters. Take a look here. Yesterday, Anna Shcherbakova, all the medalists getting requests for autographs. Young people inspiring other young people. Such a good thing to see here. The Junior Grand Prix spreads inspiration for the next generation of young skaters at home, whatever level those young kids are at. So wonderful to see. We hope to be able to inspire more young skaters as we move forward to the Czech Republic and to Slovenia, then to Armenia for the first time. Going to Yerevan, Armenia. Never been there. Looking very much forward to meeting the people in that country. Visiting the city. And a look at the standings so far in the men's event towards the Junior Grand Prix Final. Andrew Togashev of the United States, he's locked up 24 points. Roman Salveson, 18. Danielle Grauzel of Italy, 18. Steven Gogolev, now he's in this competition. He needs to grab number one or two spot. Going to move up a long ways to grab that and secure that position in the Junior Grand Prix Final. So a lot of pressure here for Steven. He's about 7 to 10 points out of silver or bronze. Let's see what happens. A number of the top men have another event to skate. Building is filling up. There's a look at the starting order for Group 3, just finishing up the warm-up. Great participation by the local skating clubs in Richmond and in Vancouver. And we put a request out for people to send their pictures of their pets as they're watching. Here's from Maggie from the United States. Cute dog, just totally fascinated with the Junior Lady event being held here in Richmond. And there are many more to come. We'll get those up throughout the Junior Grand Prix. Remember, you can email me at Junior Grand Prix or jgpbarton@gmail.com. A lot of fun with that. Pretty intense beagle, I think it is.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the next competitor. Representing Sweden, Nikolai Mezhurov.
Nikolai's 18 years old, second Junior Grand Prix season. He's coached by Alexander Mezhurov Sr. and Arina Mezhurov. Skating free program here to the Adams family. Thank you. This young man has impeccable jump technique.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Sweden, Nikolai Mazurov.
On the takeoff, that is. His great jumping technique, power and explosion as he leaves the ice, looks fabulous in the air, but he's quite inconsistent with when to check out, how to stop that rotation, and make sure that he's just opening up as he makes contact to solidify the landing. I've seen him do just perfect jumps, but there's no question. But in competition, you know, the guys get all worked up and they use, maybe in some cases, too much power. Over-rotate, get a little higher than they normally do. Take a look here. Triple Lutz, a bit of a lean on this fall, but great speed. Look at the air tummy he has. He's a little bit too far forward. Right over top, triple axel, watch this. Great takeoff, arms and free leg, lift him way up, but he slipped on that takeoff edge, took him off kilter. A little bit of a lean, here's the triple loop. That was pretty good into the toe loop. Another triple flip here. And an Oiler into a double salchow. Pretty strong skater. Solid technique, great in the air. There's a double axel. Again, maybe bigger than what he normally does. Sort of out jumps himself to a little bit with all the adrenaline in competition. Here's the triple Lutz. How beautiful that is in the air, but again, slow checkout. Really gets stuck in front, back of the blade, those types of things. He's so close to being so incredibly precise with the technique. With landing each jump clean, the GOE, the quality, would go way up. He probably lost, I don't know, maybe a good 10 points on just the quality in the landings. But boy, can this young man jump. Good spinner as well. Mean all that in the most positive way, of course.
The scores
lands
please.
All that. Wow.
Nikolai Mazurov from Sweden has earned
108.92. That's the season's best for Nikolai. That's first in the free program. And a total competition score so far of 169.33. Nikolai is currently in first place overall.
Please welcome the next competitor, representing Russia, Matvey Vetlugin.
Matvey, 14 years old, born in Moscow, coached by Ludmila Sapronova. Skating is free program. The soundtrack, The Greatest Showman.
Ladies and gents, this is the moment you've waited for. Been searching in the dark, your sweat soaking through the floor.
It's fire, it's freedom, it's falling open. It's a picture in the paper and your blood, your motion. There's something breaking at the brick of every wall. It's holding all that you know. This is the greatest show.
Take my hand. Ladies and gentlemen, from Russia, Matvey Vetlugin.
Little dance as he gets off the ice. What a talented young man this is, for sure. Take a look at some of the elements. He tends to go up a little open and spins fast on the way down. Okay now, because he's light. Triple nuts up, and now into an Oiler. Triple Sal, little wrap, free leg on the landing. Save it. Here's the triple flip. Triple Lutz, triple loop, little under rotated on this triple loop, little open. Just probably an under rotation there. Oh no, it's a downgrade actually in the system. Triple flip there. Really good spin. See that Arabian into the flying camel. There's the change of edge. Backward to forward inside. Back to back outside, grabs the blade, back up. That's a flying camel, level 4. Positive GE for quality. Triple toe loop at the end. Good flow on the landing. You see that nice speed and flow. Great, great shot. Nice. He's got the iPhone going already.
The scores, please. Matvey Vetlugin from Russia.
125.01. That's first so far in the free program. The total competition score of 184.78. Matvey is currently in first place overall.
Please welcome the next competitor, representing Canada, Stephen Gogolin.
Stephen, just 13 years old, from Toronto, coached by Brian Orser, Lee Barkel, choreographed by Mary Angela Larmer, David Wilson. First Junior Grand Prix season, second competition this year. Needs a good skate tonight. Sherlock Holmes is the music by Hans Zimmer. Mark.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Canada, Stephen Gobelin.
Well, you could see by Stephen's reaction at the end, shaking his head a little bit. Maybe missed the opportunity, maybe tried too hard. Look, this young man is extraordinary for the age of 13. And he can do all the elements, and he can do them beautifully, and skate well, and spin well. He does it all. Under the heat of competition, it's always the test for everyone. Let's take a look at some of these elements. Here's the quad lutz. Looks good. Gets all the way around. A little too far forward, not right on top of his foot when he landed. Triple axel. Great height, slipped a little bit on that takeoff edge, got a little outside on leaning outside, second triple axel. Works it up into a triple toe loop. That's how talented he is. Just knew where he was. He's struggling through everything. Triple Lutz, which he never misses, but stepped out of it, just struggled. And every time he went down, or every time it was a fight, you just know you have to, you're not in your zone. It's not easy tonight. It's a fight all the way. And he did. Still going to have a pretty good score. A lot of difficult elements. Not what he had hoped. There's a bright future. Many more good times yet to come. Right here, you can see him, look at him squeeze his eyes. Ah, I feel for him. But we'll see a lot of good years from him. Coach Brian Orser, genius. Such a master, knowing how to craft the athlete's career, navigate the ups and downs. Brian experienced them all in his life, so he knows exactly what this young student is going through. Program score for Stephen, 124.04. That's second in the free program so far. For the total competition score, 187.67. And is currently at the moment, he's in first place.
Please welcome the next competitor, representing Japan, Senna Miyake.
Senna, 16 years old, fourth Junior Grand Prix season, born in Okayama, coached by Yutako Nagamitsu. Skating violin concerto by Tchaikovsky.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Japan, Senna Hayaki.
Well, Senna had some trouble on the exits of these jumps. Very powerful, has lots of speed, but a little slow on the checkouts, and went down on a number of these elements or had challenges on the end of the. Here's the quad sow attempt. Nice height, straight foot right underneath him. A little bit on a lean, didn't get that free leg back. Here's the triple axle. Needs to push that free leg back, but it got stuck forward. Does a three turn. Here's the triple lutz. He does two of these. That was nice. Nice speed and flow on that landing. Here's the second one. Wants this to be a combination. Puts a free leg back. Thinks about it. No, not enough momentum. He backed off of doing the double toe or triple toe he's planning. There's the triple flip. Again, the free leg's forward. He's back on the heel. He has to flip out just to keep on his feet. Triple loop. Okay. Free leg forward, back on the heel, and fall. Wasn't on top of his skate. On the middle to forward part of the blade when he hit the ice on a landing, if you're too far back, you're going to go down or you're going to have to flip out. You need to be in the middle to the forward part. Keshi Honda in the kiss and cry with Senna. Keshi Honda, of course, a great Japanese champion, international medalist. To train here in Canada with Doug Lee out of Barrie. Now coaching and still doing shows in Japan. Had a nice conversation with Takeshi a little earlier this week.
Scores
for Senna.
Senna
free program
Miami
score
Japan
101.76. That is sixth in the free program.
With
a total competition score of 165.19. That's fourth overall for the moment.
In fourth place.
Seven skaters yet to compete.
Please welcome the next competitor, representing Canada, Barris Clement.
Barris, 16 years old, born in Langley, first junior Grand Prix season, second event, coach and choreographer Joanne McLeod. Personal best so far this season, 93.18 in the free program, earning that week two in Austria, skating this free program to Gladiator by Hans Zimmer. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Canada, Perez Clemens.
Good work by Perez this afternoon. It wasn't all perfect, and he fought through everything, and he didn't back down. He gained experience in Austria, made a couple, let's say, mental errors, but choices, perhaps, that he didn't fall into here. Here's the double axel. Look at the speed and the flow through the air, and the speed on the landing is spectacular. Just a little lazy with that free leg. You got to punch that back. Can't hope that it's going to happen. You've got to make it happen. There's the triple Lutz. Has to adjust and does. He gets a triple toe loop done. Boy, he had to work through that, and he did. He stayed with it. There's a triple loop. A little bit forward, but works through it. He didn't let anything get him down. Now, this is the one element that went quite a bit off. That's okay. A little wide on the takeoff. Pick foot inside, the takeoff foot on the outside. Didn't back it up, but that's okay. That was the one error. Then he comes down. There's the triple flip. Gets the free leg back, double toe, double loop. Solid there. Kept his focus. Triple salchow, and this got messy a little bit. He has a great triple salchow, but didn't lift very high. Didn't have enough time to check out. And the combination spin needs some work on that camel spin for sure. Much better by Barris here. Learning every time out. Gaining some confidence and understanding of what you have to do in the competition under the stress. Experience gained. Not a very expressive guy at this point in his career. He's learning how to feel this out. A lot of work to do in that area, but making improvements all the time. Let's take a look at the free program scores. 111.98. That's the season's best for Barris. Good for him. And that's third in the free program. The total competition score of 172.76. That puts Barris currently third overall.
Please welcome the skaters of the final warm-up group to the ice. From France, Adam Xiao Himfa. From Russia, Peter Guminik. From the United States of America, Peter Liu. From Japan, Yuma Kageyama. From Canada, Ilya Kovler. From the United States of America, Tomoki Hiwatashi. Skaters, you have 6 minutes for your warm-up.
Just another look at the top men trying to work for those points for the Junior Grand Prix Final. Andrew Turgashev, 24 points. Roman Salveson, 18. And Danielle Grazel, 18. Now, Danielle's got already two competitions done. I believe Roman as well. Steven Gogolev, very important that he climbed those ranks here today. He's got 15 points for a win. He's first right at the moment. Six skaters yet to come. So his journey to the Grand Prix Final still in doubt. See what happens. Camden Polkinen has a win as well with 15. We'll see him a little bit later in the series. And a look at the start order for Group 4. Anything can happen. We're all capable. Let's see. And remember to follow us on all the social media, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and Twitter. Again, you can send me your emails, your stories about skating, about the Junior Grand Prix, which you're doing terrific. We have so many, about over 400. Wonderful to read the stories from our fans around the world. JGP, BARTON at gmail.com.
Thank you.
Here we go. Final group of men. Stay tuned.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the next competitor representing France. Adam,
17 years old, born in Bordeaux, third Junior Grand Prix season, coached by Brian Gilbert, choreographed by Nikolai Morozov. Skating the free program this afternoon here in Richmond. The Weight of Love, performed by the Black Keys.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, from France, Adam Sialhinma.
Well, Adam is such a powerful and aggressive skater. He skates all out. The first part of the program, you're fresh and you can control that power. The last part of the program, everything fires a little bit slower. You have less control. We see this falling out of some of the elements in the end of the program. He's still aggressive and using all the momentum, maybe a little less control because he doesn't have as much control of those muscles as they start to fatigue. This is just a normal process. Really, look at the speed. There's the quad, nice and high, gets it down up into the triple toe loop. Wow. Very solid, very patient between the two jumps. That was smart. Triple axel, a little bit of a lean on the takeoff, but he gets it corrected in midair, up into a double toe. Watch him power off, and he shoves that triple axel way up in the air. In fact, over-rotates it. Why he didn't have a clean landing on that. And the quad toe, watch this. Very hard fall, but on a big lean, doesn't get much of his weight on his feet to help absorb it. Goes down on all fours. Here's the triple lutz. Good control here. Euler, patience, triple sal, work. Triple loop, just a little tired near the end of the program on a lean slightly, hand goes down. Don't have the control over the middle part of your body as much. Very technical, powerful skater.
The scores, please. Adam Sialhinma.
Free program scores for Adam, 133.29. That's first in the free program. Nod of approval from Brian's coach. Total competition score, 199.14. Adam is currently in first place.
Please welcome the next competitor, representing Russia, Peter Gumenik.
Peter, 16 years old, born in St. Petersburg, third junior Grand Prix season, coached by Veronica Denico. Choreographed by Alexandra Pavlova, skating the free program to Romeo and Juliet. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Russia, Peter Gumenik.
Oh, what a beautiful skater, Hasek. Wonderful posture. He holds his body alignment so consistent throughout the program, which makes it so much easier in jumps and in spins. Has a lot of off-ice training, I'm sure. Dance training, you can see his shoulders are down, the back is straight. Boy, aerodynamical. Here's a triple axel right off the takeoff. Look at the height on that, right in the triple loop. Worked and fought for that. Got it done. Here's another triple axel. Lifts himself way up, pretty forward on the landing. That's okay. He won't get great quality points, but he'll get the points for the element. There's the triple lutz, hands over the head, reload, toe. A triple flip, double loop, double loop. You can see how straight that back is. It makes the jumping so much easier. You just start the rotation, keep your back straight, your whole body alignment all takes care of itself. Right up into the flying change combination spin at the end of his program. Beautiful. Program scores for Peter going to be good.
Peter Gumenik from Russia.
150.35. That's first in the free program. Smiles. The total competition score 220.04. That's a very strong lead.
In first place.
Great job. There's a look at the top five so far.
Please welcome the next competitor, representing the United States of America, Peter Liu.
Peter, 18 years old, second Junior Grand Prix season. He's coached by Victor Pfeiffer, choreographed by Irina Romanova. Skating his free program to Rhapsody on a theme from Paganini by Sergei Rachmaninoff. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the United States of America, Peter Liu.
Well, look, there's no other way to say it. This is a good skater who had a very bad day at the office. It just didn't work out for him on a number of the jumps. Obviously, he can do them. You can see that the technique is there. The power, the strength is there. Wasn't balanced on the landing. A little slow on some areas. We'll take a look at some of these elements. Here's the triple axel off the top. All the way. Free leg back of the heel. Free leg is forward. Can't get that free leg back. You're not going to stand up. And here's the second triple axel. This was way off center. Didn't even get around all the way. Slipped off the back of the edge. There's the triple Lutz. Again, too far back. Now you're searching for things. What can I get? Get myself back into the game. There it was. Triple loop. That was good. Triple flip. Gets that free leg back. Kind of slow, though. You know, he's just everything is sluggish on those landings. You can't be. You got to stick the landing by pushing those arms out, getting the free leg back right away. A little bit better, but forward. Okay, got that done. And then the change combination's been lost. Balance on that as well. Is it just a bad day at the office for a very good skater? Fortunate. But it happens to everyone. Pre-programmed score for Peter.
From the United States of
95.12. That's 12th in the pre-program so far. With a total competition score of 158.83. That's 9th overall.
Currently in 9th place. Please welcome the next competitor, representing Japan, Yuma Kageyama.
Yuma, 15 years old, first junior Grand Prix season. Choreographed by Masao Sato. He's getting his free program to music by Naoki Sato.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Japan, Yuma Kageyama.
This young man is so light on his feet. Deep, deep knees. We'll see that on the landings of his jumps. Struggled a little bit during the program, and during the program had to fight to keep on his feet, keep the quality up as high as he can, get every point out. No one has really skated that terrific. There's a pop on the triple axel. Lost a lot of points on that. Watch the landing of the triple flip. Watch how low goes on the knees. See nice soft knees with that running edge, carrying that flow. Beautiful. Here's the triple lutz. Soft knee. Great curve. Fast run of his blade. There's the triple loop. Soft knee. Triple flip, triple toe action here. Good speed between the two. Soft knee. Those knees are real blessing. They help to stabilize, absorb the pounding coming down from the air. Like shock absorbers. Some people don't use them very well, but this gentleman does, for sure. Program score for Yuma.
Yuma Kageyama from Japan.
119.13. That's fifth in the short program, the free program, pardon me. With a total competition score of 194.73. That is third overall. There's a look at your top five. Two more yet to skate.
Please welcome the next competitor, representing Canada, Ilya Cobbler.
Ilya, 15 years old, out of Toronto, Ontario. Second Junior Grand Prix season, coaching choreographed by Andrei Berintsev, Inga Zuzev. Skating free program to Writings on the Wall, the James Bond soundtrack performed by Sam Smith.
changed.
You expect me to talk?
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Canada, Ilya Kovler.
Well, Ilya's shaking his head right now going, what happened? What happened? First of all, let's talk about the axle. You need to be right on top of the axle takeoff edge to be able to make a triple axle. If your edge slips out, it's going to pop, number one. Number two is he found himself in the top in the short program, and he wanted it so bad. He wasn't in the moment. He was hoping this was going to happen. Results can't happen until you systematically produce what you are able to do, and then you take a look at the end of the program. He wanted it so bad. Watch the takeoff edge. Just hit the pick too early. Popped into a single. Second triple axel. Nope, sorry. Here's the triple flip. A lean, but he stays on his feet, gets it done. Here's the second triple axel. Watch the takeoff edge. Slips right out just a couple inches before he hit the pick. He wasn't right on top of that foot. Here's the triple Lutz on the lean. Can't get the free leg back. Going, oh boy, this is getting out of control. Triple flip. Okay, gets it done. A little bit forward. For the steps. How do you keep yourself focused? How do you fight back in the program when things just don't feel right? You can see, there it is. The look on his face. What happened? What just happened?
Hi, everybody.
I know that this may be a bad day for Ilya, but this is a day he will learn the most, perhaps, in his career. Being where he wanted to be in the top three, having the opportunity. Letting it get away. He won't have that happen again, I'm most certain.
Ilya
it's too good.
From Canada.
Take a look at the free program score, 102.44 for the free. That's 10th so far in the free program. The total competition score of 174.60. Overall, that puts Ilya Kovler of Canada currently into sixth place. One skater yet to come.
Please welcome our final competitor, representing the United States of America, Tomoki Hiwatashi.
Tomoki, 18 years old, born in Inglewood, New Jersey, fourth junior Grand Prix season, coached by Christy Krall, choreographed by Mark Belay and Ben Augusto. Skating his free program, final skater of the night. The fate of the gods.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the United States of America, Tomoki Kiwatashi.
Well, it wasn't without error, but I think this young man put himself in the running for the possibility of the Junior Grand Prix final. He still has another event to come, but he fought his way through this program. He had a lot of technical elements. He's very agile and quick. Some rough landings for sure, but that's part of the fighting process, especially when you have a very difficult program as he does. Great soft knees. Let's take a look at some of the elements. Here's the quad toe. Great speed, nice and tight and fast. Gets the free leg back. Triple toe loop. Solid. Triple axle. He had to really fight for this. Pushes himself way up in the air. Hangs on. Second triple axle. This one had to do a three turn on the way out. Now watch this nice split jump here. Little cantilever into the split jump. Very nice. Into the triple salchow. Good transitions right up into and throughout that jumping sequence. Triple loop. Forward. Kind of weird landing forward and went back the other direction. So again, just loses some quality but gets the points for the jump. There's triple Lutz. Euler. Double flip. And some pretty cool moves right here in the middle of a step sequence. There's a Rabian with an illusion. Continues on with some deep edges. And final spin. Smiles all around. In the kiss and cry. We'll see if it's enough to keep the title, to take the title.
The scores, please.
Here it is. Pre-program score.
Tomoki Kiwatashi of the United States
136.43. That's second in the free program. And a total competition score of 213.24. That's second.
He's currently in second place. Ladies and gentlemen, this completes the men's competition. Victory ceremonies will take place following.
There's a look at the final result. Peter of Russia, 220.04. Tomoki of the United States, 213.24. And in third place, Adam from France, 199.14. Top three, and a look at the rest of the field. Well, that concludes our coverage of the men's free program. The final event of week four of the Junior Grand Prix coming up. That'll be the free program. There's a look at the schedule. Paris Free will take to the ice here at 16:10. And a look at the rest of the schedule. Week off next week will be in the Skate Canada Autumn Classic in Oakville, Ontario. And then we'll move on to Ostrava, Czech Republic for week five, Ljubljana for week six, Yerevan, Armenia for week seven, and then the Junior and Senior Grand Prix Final in Vancouver, December 6th tonight. That concludes our coverage of the men's free program. I hope you'll join us for the Paris Prix coming right up.